It's a rather interesting controversy over, you know, the Second Amendment and people weighing in on one side or the other. And there was kind of an interesting tweet out there by a Republican congressman, and they have an argument against this, Jack Posobiec, I guess is his name, and he says, there's never been a terrorist attack at a NASCAR race. NASCAR fans are all armed.
I've seen that post.
Draw your own conclusions. Well,
I mean, baseball game? Never, right?
Yeah, right.
Football game?
Okay.
Never?
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Well, match?
The best retort to it is George Takei.
Takei.
My apologies. Rhymes with gay, George Takei.
That's a good way to remember.
He tweeted this out. There's never been a terrorist attack at a nudist colony. Nudists aren't armed. They're nude. Draw your own conclusions. I love George Takei.
And he loves you, too. You know what he thinks of you, Paul?
Paul and Al. You are a rich, gooey devil's food cake that I want to drop my face into and go...
Hey, thanks for... Monday morning at 8:35 on the Paul and Al Show, we got some great tickets to give away. Jeff Dunham, funniest guy you'll ever see, is coming to Mohegan Sun on July 21st, and that's a Friday night, by the way. And we will have your tickets starting Monday morning at 8:35 right here at 94HAY.
The DJ was yesterday, and if you missed it, well, we've got the highlights for you right here.
What do you call a book club that's stuck on the same book for thousands of years?
The
Catholic Church.
Right.
Our buddy Wheels has a few jokes on the Paul and Al Facebook page. Boss says, hey, Wheels, I know your hours are usually 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., but can you please work an hour later tomorrow? I said, sure, I'll see you at 10 a.m. And then this classic one from Rick. I scared the postman today by going to the door completely naked. I'm not sure what freaked him out more, my naked body or the fact that I knew where he lived.
HJY, hi.
All right, so a man and his wife are going to go to Jamaica for their anniversary, and the husband decides that he's going to surprise her with a new tattoo. And he gets her name tattooed on his penis. When he goes home, he shows his wife. And his wife says, that's nice, but what does WY stand for? He says, rub it and you'll find out. As he grows harder, it reads out Wendy. Now they go to Jamaica and they're walking along the nude beach. And he sees another man with WY tattooed on his penis. He says, hey, what, do you have a wife named Wendy, too?
He goes, no, rub it. And it says, welcome to Jamaica. I hope you have a wonderful, fantastic, sunny day.
You got it.
All right. And this week's winner of something, DJ, is Jeffrey Littlefield. He sent in a bunch of good jokes.
You know, the first time I met my wife, my head was spinning and my knees were going weak. It was then I realized I put the roofie in the wrong drink. That must be Bill Cosby's.
Yeah, right.
I made my wife's dreams come true when we were married in a castle, but you sure wouldn't have known it from the look on her face as we were bouncing around. Jeff also writes, you know, I've learned that if you upset your wife, she nags you. But if you upset her even more, you get the silent treatment. Does anybody else think it's worth the extra effort?
Before you hit the pillow tonight, pray that your kids don't turn out like these clowns.
They are idiots at this age.
The best of Paul and Al on 94 HJY.
A guy in Illinois jumped in a river on Thursday to avoid paying his bar tab.
That's happened at the hot club more times than you can imagine.
I know. The owner of the hot club dumped a drink on me once and didn't apologize. I was a little upset about that. Cops searched for him for 24 hours, but apparently he's still missing. I kind of like gave him the pass because I was like, oh, he seems drunk. And then I was like, well, he's the owner. Buy me a drink, you know?
Really?
You dumped a drink on me,
He did
dude.
Buy you a drink. He just dumped it on you.
Yeah, well, who am I going to do, suck on my jeans in front of everybody?
Gym. Tell you what, if you suck on your jeans and post it at 94HJY.com,
you're
going
to
want to hear.
Some Rhode Islanders find the Paul and Al Show very interesting. No, really, they do. The best of Paul and Al on 94 HJY.
Wonder Woman debuted with over $100 million this past weekend. It's so funny how, you know, some of the guy reviewers, they still can't be like, hey, it's pretty good for a woman.
It's like,
you know, really? Can you just get over it?
Yeah, please.
Wonder Woman is number one at the box office. And here's what critics are saying.
I can't wait to see what the studios do with this character moving forward. And I can't wait to see Wonder Woman again.
And here's what fans are saying.
I love Wonder Woman. I definitely can't wait to see it again.
And here's what perverts are saying about Wonder Woman star Gal Gadot.
Ooh, I want you to whip me with that lasso, Diana.
Ooh. All right, you freak. We're getting complaints from the customers. You have to leave the theater.
Wait, no, wait.
Then we'll just escort you out.
You can't go. I paid good money for my ticket.
Let's go, buddy.
There's not one sign in this movie theater saying you have to wear your pants while watching this movie. Let's go.
Wonder Woman. Now showing at a theater that requires you to keep your pants on near you.
Paul and Al. Mornings on 94. HJY.
Finally going to get you high.
That's going to be an accomplishment, Paul. High on life, Paul.
Well, we're going to get you high on marijuana because This is wonderful news. A medical marijuana clinic in Quincy, Mass.
Uh-huh.
Is selling a marijuana-infused pizza.
Nice.
Okay. That's the way to get you on board
that
with the 420 Club.
Good introductory plan.
Six-inch cheese pizzas are selling for $38 a piece.
Wow. Want it delivered, it's going to be $50.
Better ingredients, right? Better pot.
I'll say.
The tomato sauce contains 125 milligrams of THC. That's the psychoactive compound in marijuana. So far, they've sold 200, like right out of the gate.
To the same guy.
And to rave reviews.
All right.
Well, you know, you can freeze it at home, reheat it when you want.
Oh, my God, you're kidding. That is fantastic.
Who needs oregano, right, when you've got pot?
By the way, of course, medical marijuana legal pretty much everywhere now. And you know what? They celebrate marijuana in a place called Amsterdam. And a little heads up that HJY, after more than a decade, we are going back to Amsterdam. Doug and Scarpetti are hosting the trip for the Cannabis Cup.
You know, prohibited from going for 10 years.
They may find the remains of Jeff Charles somewhere in one of those coffee shops.
And don't ask what Charles smuggled in a certain body orifice back from Amsterdam.
Oh, that's a classic story.
It is a legend around the radio station.
So here it is. Amazing packages for 4 or 5 nights departing November 16th. The rates start at about $10.94 per person based on double occupancy, which you can't beat that deal.
That's fantastic. All I can say is the result of Charles' smuggling, where interns going, this came from where? Out of what?
Come on, it was protected by a condom.
Hey, you can get all the details on this awesome trip at 94HJY.com right now.
Pulling out.
HJY is the best station. The best station on HJY.
On 94. HJY.
Hey, thanks for listening. 94HJY. It's brought to you by our friends at Dunkin' Donuts. Monday morning at 8:35 on the Paul and Al Show, we got some great tickets to give away. Jeff Dunham, funniest guy you'll ever see, is coming to Mohegan Sun on July 21st, and that's a Friday night, by the way. And we will have your tickets starting Monday morning at 8:35 right here at 94HJY.
Jen, what you got here?
A police dog in Australia was just fired because he liked belly rubs too much. He's going to work as a greeting dog for the government instead.
Get that bad guy.
All right. Who's a good boy? Who's a good boy?
Can you imagine?
His little leg is pumping as fast as it can go.
Like, passed all the tests, but like the second you want the guy to, you know.
They had the dog Oscar last night at the revival brewery. Yeah.
And
like where the actual brewing gets done, downstairs. Stairs, it's a cement floor. And Oscar's, he's just kind of mowing along, and then all of a sudden he says, you know what, I think I'm going to lay down. So it's just like the four legs just spread out right on the floor right there. It's like flop.
Oscar's got a good gig because all that beer that trickles into the drains in the floor, he's licking it up.
Of course we had food on the buffet table. Anything that hit the floor was picked up in an instant.
Sweet dog.
And he loves belly rubs.
By the way, very proud of you guys for not coming in hungover today. Y'all look like you've
got a little headache going.
Oh, come on.
Yeah. Do
ya? Beer, for crying out loud.
Well, look at him. He's hurting.
He's a pussy.
I'm not hurting. I am a pussy, but
edit.
Come on. Paul and Al. God, you're pathetic. HJY.
It's 94 HJY. Interesting stuff going viral over the weekend with David Lee Roth for some reason, a couple of old interviews, but
yeah, we
somebody
pretty much forgotten about him, you know?
And there's always the debate, and I know what a huge Van Halen fan you are. I mean, we're big Van Halen fans, but you're like obsessed.
Kevin is
with
obsessed.
The band. And we always had the debate between Sammy and David Lee. I prefer the David Lee Van Halen, at least the first two albums.
My favorite era was Gary Cherone.
That was shining.
No. You know what? That debate is very tough for me. I mean, because I love them both. Okay. And I guess if
what
I
you,
had...
What are you, a politician? What are you going to be running for governor here?
But I will say this. When Dave and Sammy toured together, Sammy blew him off the stage.
Oh, really? Yeah.
So Sammy obviously is the better talent vocally.
Certainly, now.
But the lyrics that Sammy writes are often very infantile.
Okay.
David Lee Roth's lyrics were cool.
Dave's a better entertainer, right?
But a bit more full of himself.
If they were to reunite, like, because I think they're done now, David Lee Roth's voice is gone. I'd rather see them back with Sammy. So that was an answer and non-answer.
Now, these are, they say, the best David Lee Roth quotes ever. This sounds very David Lee Roth.
Sammy Hagar throws a party. I am the party.
That's Dave for sure.
I'm a very family-oriented kind of guy. I personally started three or four of them in 1983 alone. Ow! The reason the critics all like Elvis Costello better than me is because they all look like Elvis Costello.
You know, I just noticed something that David Lee Roth...
I think I just blew a testicle doing that one.
David Lee Roth's voice sounds like the cartoon character
Yosemite Sam.
That's it.
You know what? I would love the Al era of Van Halen. You know, I'm the rudinest, tootinest, gall darn shootinest lead singer of Van Halen there was.
Paul and Al, mornings on 94 HJY.
We touched on this yesterday, but it's very sad. The big blue bug was tagged. Nibbles Woodaway was the victim of a graffiti artist slash vandal over the weekend. The owners of the company say it's the first time Nibbles has been defaced, and they plan on putting up a security camera to prevent future copycat.
You mess with Nibbles, you're messing with Paul and Al.
I know.
Right?
Do you know who was the original voice of Nibbles Woodaway?
I do not.
They had a few commercials way back when.
You're looking at him right now.
Yeah, I was the voice of Nibbles.
You were Nibbles?
Really? Yeah. He was Nibbles.
Oh, man.
Can I have your autograph?
It was just a little buzzy kind of voice.
I have really bad news for you. I will never call you Al again. Like, you are officially Nibbles for the rest of your life.
Listen, you know what? You can call me Nibbles all you want. Just not in front of my wife. I've got enough to explain.
And the big bug on the building will be reason number three we call you Nibble.
Oh, no. Now somebody's trying to put graffiti on Al. Oh, God.
All right, I promise.
I knew a porn star named Nibbles Woodaway.
Yeah.
It was gay porn.
Paul and Al.
This is going to give you the energy to go on.
On 94 HJY.
It's 94 HJY. Jerry Remy, of course, trying to backpedal earlier this week, mentioning that they shouldn't allow translators on the mound. Basically, he was saying, learn to speak English. And his apology on Twitter was very insincere.
Ill purse.
Did an apology on the air before the game against the Yankees. And you know what? I think Jerry Remy needs a translator.
Thanks, Dave. Last night, during the course of the Red Sox-Yankee games, I made some comments that offended a number of people in our audience.
At least those of you who speak f***ing English.
I'd like to apologize to my colleagues in Nesson, to the Boston Red Sox.
The very people who wrote this apology for me and for whom I'm making a half-assed attempt to poorly read it off the teleprompter.
But most importantly, to the fans who were offended by my comments.
Even though you were so drunk by the end of the game, you totally forgot about them.
I sincerely hope you accept my apologies.
I sincerely hope you keep coming to Jerry Remy's Sports Bar and Grill and enjoying many of our daily specials.
Thank you very much.
Nesson, please don't fire me like you did to Don Orsillo.
Okay, there you go. The official translation.
Mornings on 94 HJY.
Hey, thanks for listening to the best of Paul and Al here at 94 HJY. It's brought to you by our friends at Dunkin' Donuts. Monday morning at 8:35 on the Paul and Al Show, we got some great tickets to give away. Jeff Dunham, funniest guy you'll ever see, is coming to Mohegan Sun on July 21st, and that's a Friday night, by the way. and we will have your tickets starting Monday morning at 8:35 right here at 94HAY.
An interesting fact, when you break wind, it travels at about 10 feet per second. That's about 7 miles an hour, which I would say is quite a bit faster than the majority of us can maneuver on our own 2 feet.
So, yeah, you're right.
There you go.
Outrun your own farts?
Not
I don't
likely.
Think so.
But you do have clothing to slow it down.
Yeah,
it's
true.
It's a naked fart that goes that fast.
That's good to know. I'll keep that one.
Let's do a test at Roger Williams Park this afternoon.
4 out of 5 dentists hate them. Luckily, we got the 5th one drunk.
Can't a guy sit in a closet and get drunk without being barraged by filth?
The best of Paul and Al on 94 HJY.